John Stamos, David Rains, Paul Wesley, and Maddie Ziegler. Musical performances by Jason Derulo, Church Poop, Florida, Soraya, Neo, and Kobe Bryant presents the Decade Awards for Justin Timberlake. Give it up for your host. First, he's the star of movies, host of Fox's American Grid, and 15-time WWE World Champion, John Cena.
What's up, Team Choice? All right, it's deafening, but I got help on the show. What in the name?
From the beast metropolis of Hollywood, Florida, the beast of pain, the beast of banter, and the star of the Rocky Horror Picture Show is all on Fox, Victoria!
Wrestling outfit is that? Okay, are you trying out a new WWE character, the pastel buffoon, right?
Don't laugh, that might work. I am not here to wrestle. I'm here to host, right? And guys, let's be honest. If we were to have a wrestling match, it's not exactly fair, am I right? I mean, come on.
Okay, you know what? Hold up. I have been training mentally, physically, and spiritually 8 hours a day. Now, I was promised a wrestling match with John Cena!
That happens a lot.
That is what I am gonna get!
Okay, I'm just gonna do my job now.
Oh, all really was your job getting your butt kicked? Because that's happening right now!
So, for the past 2 months, millions of you have voted for the hottest hits on film, music, fashion, sports, and the web. Would you stop it? It's your life!
I can multitask! And you chose the sign for the biggest and best trophy in the world, the Teen Choice Surfboard! You getting tired, Cena?
No, I am not. It is the award show that is all about you, your votes, your voice, and your choice.
Okay, let me know. Wait, actually, I kind of like it up here. Woo! Teen Choice!
Hijinks aside, who's ready to give out some surfboards?
This isn't over, Cena.
It absolutely is over.
In high school, he was voted most likely to be a total hottie.
She was voted most likely to become the star of Jane the Virgin.
Here's Gina Rodriguez, and from Austin and Elliot, our 5-year choice team becoming our number one friends! Yeah, so it's a little coincidental that we're doing the sci-fi category, because I just did a sci-fi thriller in London, and I asked for the Ross Lynch cut.
Oh, it looks really good.
You're welcome. Just a moment. We just wanted to take a moment from here.
That was nice.
All right, so are you Team Captain America or Team Iron Man?
What team is Scarlett Johansson?
That wasn't the question, but I think Team Iron Man.
I'm all about Scarlett Johansson. I'm on that team.
All right.
All right, let's check.
I have to standing right here.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, fine.
All right, let's check out the nominees.
Choice movie actor, sci-fi fantasy, Henry Cavill, Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice.
Stay down. If I wanted it, you'd be dead already.
Chris Evans, Captain America, Civil War.
You may not be perfect, but it's interesting and you're strong.
Chris Hemsworth, The Huntsman, Winter's War. Robert Downey Jr., Captain America, Civil War. John Hutcherson, The Hunger Games.
We're still trying to get there.
Mockingjay, Part 2.
We're really not ready.
Ben Affleck, Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice.
He has the power to wipe out the entire human race, and we believe there's even a 1% chance that he is our enemy. We have to take it as an absolute symbol.
Oh, they all look up to you.
That's awesome. Yeah. You're off. All right, and your choice movie actor for a sci-fi fantasy is... I can't drum.
I'm supposed to sing?
We could do it together.
Okay, ready? One, two, three.
Chris Evans!
Captain America Civil War is also your choice movie sci-fi fantasy.
Cool. Alright. I just wanted one of these things. Thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you so much. This really means a lot to me. I'd be lying if I said it didn't feel like a little bit of a mistake, but I'll take it. Thank you. Thank you to everyone who voted. Thank you to the teens. Thank you. Thank you to Marvel. These movies take so many people. They really deserve some credit. They do. Thank you to Kevin Feige, the big dog over at Marvel. He let Johnny Storm take a chance at trying to be Steve Rogers, so I really appreciate that. I love making these movies. I love playing this character. This makes it all the sweeter, so thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Go to the @TeenChoiceFox Instagram and to vote live the Choice website. Make sure to follow all the info below. But first, right now, hey, Cameron Dallas, everybody, what's our nominee? And Choice Social Media King winner. Cameron, this is your first circle of the day.
Wait, what?
He just walked up. Stood up for Cameron Dallas. Yeah, that's for you.
So, I literally pointed at his butt earlier and I was like, that boy looks so cool.
It's right now. It's mine.
Are you ready to play?
I love you. I love you guys.
That's incredible.
Right. Are you ready to play Teen Choice? Would you rather?
Yeah.
All right, let's go ahead and do this. Would you rather use Justin Timberlake's toothbrush or Jessica Alba's toothbrush?
Oh, man.
I would honestly choose Justin Timberlake just because I am going to wear Jessica's van.
Yeah. Would you rather wrestle
John Cena or the Bellin
Twins? Wait, what?
Would you rather wrestle John Cena or the Bellin Twins?
Oh, John Cena for sure. Just because, like, I know he'd win and all, but, like, it would be an honor.
I have faith in you. Okay, finally, would you rather road trip with Charlie Puth or Jason Derulo?
Oh, Jason Derulo's a stud. Him for sure. Yeah,
he's sitting in the car. He's gonna be off the chain. That's fantastic, because all these stars and more are gonna be coming up on Fox's Teen Choice with Cameron Dallas, everybody.
I love you guys.
Please welcome from Storks, Keegan-Michael Key.
Hello, my fellow teenage Americans. Now, as you can see, because I'm in the home stretch of my presidency, I'm dressed more on the fleek right now. I got no time, and I'm totally commando. Yep. So tonight, POTUS is going to go with the photos. And my fellow teenage Americans, it is time for me to pass the torch. Now, America has a big choice to make, and you teens, I know you want in too. Oh, I heard that. So this year, we are holding the first ever Teen Choice presidential election. That's right. Now you guys get to tell the country who you want for president, all right? Okay? But here are your candidates. I'm gonna tell you your candidates right now, okay? Here comes your candidates, right here.
Nice pantsuit, it's huge. Huge.
Nice head bagger. It's ridiculous.
All right, now, guys.
You both look great. Okay. Donald, thought you'd be taller.
What do you mean, I'm huge?
You do seem taller on TV to me. You seem a little bit.
Team Choice has teamed up with Rock the Vote, and the polls remain open for the first hour of the show. It's huge.
Here's where you go to vote. Okay, now, listen, now you have to pick one of these two major candidates, okay? There's no Ryans, guys. I don't want to see any of your Beavers or your Swifts or your Pokemons, okay? Hey, you guys, hold on a second, okay?
The winner will be revealed at the end of tonight's show.
Yes, it is the one chance for your vote to be heard because it's your future, too.
Right? Let's do the vote. Don't move.
Please welcome country music's rising star, Kelsea Ballerini, and Fox new party queens, Alessia Cara and Phoebe Rexha.
We figured since we're three sisters who sing, we wouldn't present this next award, we'd harmonize it. So, here's a little song we wrote together backstage. You ready? And the nominees for Choice TV Actor Sci-Fi Fantasy.
Choice TV actor, sci-fi fantasy. Andrew Lincoln, The Walking Dead.
It's open! We gotta do this now!
Paul Wesley, The Vampire Diaries. Joseph Morgan, The Originals.
What are your intentions for my sister? Should we discuss it that way?
Jared Padalecki, Supernatural.
My books here, in the world, coming to me, all that.
Ian Somerhalder, The Vampire Diaries.
You should probably skip the check.
Grant Gustin, The Flash.
You will be a hero.
Heroes die.
Only if you can catch them.
And your choice TV actor, sci-fi fantasy, is Grant Gustin.
This is crazy! It's cool art this year, right?
I like it.
Thank you guys so much. This is really cool. Thank you for voting. I've got the coolest job in the world. I love to play this character. I get to work with the best casting crew and creative team in the business, so I just love my job. And thank you guys for voting for me. I love you too. I'm out of here! Thank you guys. This is awesome. Woo.
Welcome to 3-time Teen Choice winners, Leah Michelle, and your choice web star, fashion and beauty, Bethany Boda.
Welcome, you guys. Congrats on joining the 3-time Winners Club, Bethany.
I truly have my audience to thank for the constant support, and congrats to you too.
Well, thank you. The Teen Choice fans are very loyal, and not just to me. Over the last 17 years of Teen Choice, only 6 shows have ever won for Choice TV Drama, and 2 of them are up for it again this year.
Wow, let's check out the nominees.
Choice TV Show, Drama. Shades of Blue.
The good news, the angel, use Christina as influence. Everything that you said,
I think we're
gonna
do
it again.
Rosewood.
I like the
work
you're doing.
I was gonna raise it. Thanks.
Welcome back.
Pretty Little Liars.
This is gonna hurt. We gotta go back to Logan before anyone notices this. Someone can just knock on our door.
Grey's Anatomy.
You think you're making all these choices and building this life when none of this is actually yours?
What are you saying?
Get your own life.
Empire.
Look at this moment. Subconscious. All the harm I've done to each and every one.
Gotham.
I should warn you, Mr. Midler. Mr. Stirk has been known to eat people.
And the winner for Choice TV Show Drama is
Pretty Little Liars.
Accepting on behalf of Pretty Little Liars are your Choice TV Actress Drama, Ashley Benson, along with your Choice TV Chemistry co-winner, Tyler Lockburn, Troyan Belisario, Lucy Hale, your Choice TV Actor Drama winner, Ian Harney, Shay Mitchell, your Choice TV Sink Stealer, Sasha Petersa, and your Choice TV Villain, Janelle Parrish.
Hi, guys. Thank you. This is awesome. It's been a crazy ride, 7 years. So thank you for voting. Without you guys, we wouldn't be having an amazing, successful TV show for the last 7 years. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
We love you guys. Thank you.
I can dance like this for days.
Oh, that's cute. You think you're dancing?
You don't like this?
Please, John, you wouldn't know dancing if I twerked in your face.
You think you're better than me?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Dance off right now.
Okay, you know what? Hold up. We need dance experts.
Where are we going to find dance experts on a day like tonight?
It's me, John.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the dance experts from Choice Summer TV Show nominee, So You Think You Can Dance, Kat Deely, and your Choice female dancer, Matt Ziegler.
Hello.
Thank goodness you're here.
Yeah. No worries. Okay, are you ready to give us everything you've got?
I am.
Yes, you are?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. You have 10 seconds to show us your best moves. And the clock starts now.
The great one.
It's the robot, and there's some waving going on.
I
Okay, well, what do you call that then?
The best dancing you've ever seen in your life.
I was very good.
I don't think so.
No. I think it's time to call in the professionals to show you how it's done. Okay, here are the stars of Foxy. So you're thinking and dance the next generation!
Like I need a big gun. Cool if you want to move. If you want to try to have a week, maybe you will come on the bus. When you move the numbers, all the haters don't come on the lid. They jump behind your back and they breath is speaking on the spot.
Guys, we're going to be playing Kiss, Marry, Dance. You guys know how this works, right? You have your three options. We have John Stamos, Justin Timberlake, and Charlie Puth. Quite an age range there, but you guys know how to play. You guys ready for this? Okay, the count of three. One, two, three, go!
Okay.
Okay, interesting? Interesting? You're dancing with daddy. I'm going to make you look like a fool.
You're the best.
You're the best. You said daddy for John Stamos?
Yeah.
You know what, the answer's own. Okay, now let's play a new game. It's called Help Me Read the Prompter.
Oh, all these stars and more right here on Fox's Teen Choice Awards when we come back.
Oh, well done. You guys are right on my side.
You have never seen it before.
You can follow its Sour Patch Snaps on Snapchat. Everyone's excited because when doing that, they get to see exclusive behind-the-scenes footage of the teal carpet and of backstage.
And now, please welcome from Modern Family the very lovely Sarah Hyland.
And from Scream Queens, the equally lovely John Stamos.
Yes, Haley. Sorry.
It's okay. We're on live TV and here for one thing and one thing only, and that is to present the next award. What were you thinking? Come on.
I saw a Pikachu over there.
Oh, no, it's not over there. It's over there. Right there, come. Here are your nominees for Choice Summer TV Show.
Choice Summer TV Show. Teen Wolf.
I'm going to need you crazy.
Just tell me how to fix this, all right?
Baby Daddy.
I'm sure you heard that Danny baited him and is moving on the play.
Young and Hungry.
Yeah, try to walk forward, smile more, laugh harder, and you know, not somewhere you just corner on
The Fosters.
You're a bummer, you're not a fighter.
Okay, try to control yourselves until I do this. What are you doing?
So you think you could dance the next generation? Girl Meets World.
I heard that you confessed to friendships people in high school.
And your Choice Summer TV Show is Teen Wolf!
Accepting on behalf of Teen Wolf are Tyler Posey and your Choice Summer TV actress, Shelly Hunnid.
Hi, everybody. So before we get into the acceptance, Shelly Hennig also won her first award. Let's give it up for Shelly, baby.
You rigged it, didn't you?
I did.
Don't answer that. Thank you.
I love you guys, too. Honestly, we've been coming to the Teen Choice Awards for, I think, the last 7 or 8 years, something like that now, as long as Teen Wolf has been alive. And this is, these are always just the greatest things. I'm so full of love, and we love each other so much, and love all of you guys so much. And this is the last season of Teen Wolf. My man, click. So we just want to say thank you to Fox, to Teen Choice Awards, to every single one of you beautiful people. You're the only reason that we're here, and we truly do love every single one of you. So let's make this last season one to remember. We truly, truly love you all, and I'm being played off, but I want to go pee. I love you all. Let's kick some ass.
Sweet. Interesting, I am Quentin Anderson, but you guys can tell from that that we're playing the Not My Arms Challenge right now. All right, you guys ready for this?
Yes.
Okay, so tell us who's coming up next right now.
Next up, there's a performance by Charlie Puth.
Okay, there we go, Charlie Puth.
Basketball superstar Kobe Bryant to present to you Justin Timberlake. Yeah, well, dance moves.
Oh, that's Justin Timberlake. All right,
Justin,
guys, you're bringing sexy back in a really weird way. All right, stick around for Fox and Teen Choice Awards.
And a host of FS1's Garbage Time with Katie Nolan, Katie Nolan.
Hey, Teen Choice, should we get some music up in here?
Hey, we better. Who do y'all think, Sony? I'm telling your mom. Here with this international hit, We Don't Talk Anymore.
Give it up for Charlie P. Presidential election, so let your voice be heard.
Okay, now here to present the next award. You know what? I can't do this anymore. I can't.
Why? Why?
Just look. Look at everyone. We're all just taking selfies. I mean, look, they're actually taking selfies.
Hey, I see you duck facing. Stop that right now.
No, it's okay. takers. No negotiating with selfie takers. But I say, if we can't beat them, we should join them.
30-second selfie challenge. Whoever gets the most selfies wins.
Wait, 30-second selfie challenge? I will 30-second selfie crush you!
3, 2, 1, selfie! Challenge, which was definitely me.
Totally won that one. Here's your choice TV actress, sci-fi fantasy from Once Upon a Time, Lana Parrilla.
And my choice for hottest vampire from Vampire Diaries, Paul Wesley.
We are here to present your choice TV show comedy.
There are three things you need to make a great comedy: a hilarious script, brilliantly funny actors, and perfect comedic...
The nominees are...
Timing.
Choice TV show. Comedy. Austin and Ally. Luke and Maddie. Modern Family. Jane the Virgin. Fuller House. Scream Queens. That way.
And your choice TV show comedy is...
Fuller House are your choice TV actress, comedy, Camden Cameras Burr, Andrew Barber, Sony Nicole Brinkus, Michael Campion, Elias Harcher, Jody Sweeten, and executive producer, Jeff Franklin.
Oh, you would look so fierce. It's beyond me. All right. You know what I'd rather actually have you guys do right now? Why don't you take us out?
Okay. More Fox Teen Choice Wars coming up!
Yeah. I'm done. I don't need to do my job anymore.
Welcome back, Teen Choice! Woo! That's like you say Teen Choice and then they scream really loud, but I need better than that. Welcome back, Teen Choice! Yes, there we are. Now we are ready to go. We only have a few minutes left to vote for your Teen Choice president.
So go online right now and tell us who you want in the White House.
Okay, now I want you to tell us about your new special this fall on Fox, The Rocky Horror Picture Show. What's it about?
Okay, so I played Jenna Weiss, who just got engaged to a guy named Brad. Then our car gets a flat tire in a huge rainstorm. Then we go to a nearby castle for help, and living there is an alien mad scientist.
Play by me.
Okay, this is awesome. Then what?
Then I built a monster named Rocky. Not as big and as sexy and as gorgeous as Utah. We dance the time warp and we live happily ever after.
Sort of.
Wait, you guys end the show in the rain?
No, we just like squirting you.
That's a running gag. Please welcome the 4-time Teen Choice winner and 5-time NBA champion, the Black Mamba himself, Kobe Bryant! Thank you. It's great to be back here at the Forum. I have a lot of great memories of playing here. But tonight, I'm here to present the first ever Teen Choice Decade Award to the artist who has dominated the world of entertainment in the last 10 years, Justin Timberlake. Music, movies, television, music videos, fashion, whatever JT takes on, he dominates. Nobody else on the planet can touch his 9 Grammy Awards, 4 MTV Video Music Awards, 4 Emmy Awards, and 3 People's Choice Awards. Time Magazine named him one of the most influential people in the world. And GQ Magazine crowned him the most stylish man in America. But rather than me talking about why he deserves this honor, why don't I just show you?
Over the last decade, Justin Timberlake has established himself as one of the biggest artists in the world. Music, movies, TV, drama, comedy, it doesn't matter. He does it all.
I just burnt my lips with some hot cheese sauce.
This guy's gonna turn out to be
a king.
Chicken to the bridge.
Hey, baby.
Sing the song in your tents and look at the camera.
First time that I hosted, the whole thing was a blur.
I love you too.
When are you gonna make some more music?
Alright, you know what? That's it. I'm trying to take this seriously. I'm trying to take this seriously.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What happened?
What do you think about dinner?
Are we together?
Well, a little forward, don't you think? But yeah, if you're asking me out, I accept.
Take back the night.
That's it. Why are you sneezing? Just allergic to nuts.
I don't sing, and I don't relax.
He's a household name, a national treasure, and a worldwide icon. Guys want to be him. Girls scream when they see him. And everybody likes him. Talent, music, passion, drive, laughter, and love. That makes a decade award winner. And that is Justin Timberlake.
And tonight, there's one more milestone for this king of all media. The Teen Choice Decade Award and his 23rd surfboard, the most of any guy in history. I'm not just a fan, I consider myself a friend. And I'm honored to present this first ever Teen Choice Decade Award to Justin Timberlake.
You guys, this is Kobe Bryant.
This is the only time I'm taller than you.
Thank you, Teen Choice. As a former teen, a while ago, who's made a few choices along the way, I'm here to tell you that you and your choices matter. In my case, I grew up in Millington, Tennessee, just outside of Memphis. All right, one guy. Appreciate it. Where I was blessed to be raised by parents and a family who taught me some big lessons. They taught me to respect them, they taught me to respect myself, and to respect all people on the basis of their character. Not where they live, not what they did for a living, or the color of their skin. My parents did their best to fill my young mind, not with prejudice or hate, but with compassion and love. I think it's part of the reason why, to this day, I try to live my life working most closely with, making music with, and spending so much of my time with an amazing group of people, male, female, straight, gay, every walk of life. People who help each other and find a common ground. I was drawn to all these people not because they look like me, but because they think and feel like me. The truth is, we are all different, but that does not mean we all don't want the same thing. So, message. So, to all you teens out there, I ask you to not learn from my example, but from the example of all the greats who have come before me. For me, a big moment growing up was when I discovered that there was a music legend living right down the street from me, the Reverend Al Green, who taught the world a lesson that resonates now, I think, more than ever. Let's stay together. I learned from so many music greats, Michael Jackson, Aretha Franklin, Elton John, Garth Brooks, Stevie Wonder. I even learned a lot from the guy standing, not as tall as me right now, but standing next to me on stage on how to arrive early and stay late, because that's how you become a champion. Now, speaking of great, it is warm in here. It is really warm in here. Speaking of great champs, I believe we can all learn from the greatest of all time, a man who grew up just 400 miles down the road from me in Louisville, Kentucky, Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali fought in the ring, but he fought for peace too. And he became the heavyweight champion of the world because, as we all know, he could float like a butterfly and... That's right. Now, our world lost that champ this year. So tonight, I want to share three pieces of his undying wisdom that has helped me and may help you along your journey. Number one, the champ said this: don't count the days, make the days count. Pretty good. Now, you are young,
as I once was,
but do not think for a moment that what you do doesn't count. It does. Not just to you, but also to the world and your generation, who will someday inherit this world from old-timers like, I can call you old-timer now, from me and Kobe, old-timers like me and Kobe. Number two, the champ said this: service to others is the rent you pay for your room here on Earth. So be generous, be kind, be fair. It's not just the right thing to do, it's the good thing to do. And I think we all can agree that with all the tension in the world today that can divide us, we should be part of the solution and not part of the problem. And you don't have to make a difference on a global stage. You can volunteer in your neighborhood or in another neighborhood nearby where people might look a little different from you and they might teach you a thing or two. So third, and finally, here's maybe the greatest thing a teen or anyone in this room and who's watching on the television at home can learn from the champ. These are words to remember when anyone tries to tell you to give up, tell you to give in, because whatever you're trying to do is impossible. The champ said this: impossible is just a word thrown around by small men who find it easier to live in the world they've been given than to explore the power they have to change it. Impossible is not a fact, it's an opinion. Impossible is potential. Impossible is temporary. Impossible is nothing. Greatest quote ever. So, as a relatively new dad and a former teen, I'm here to say you will make mistakes along the way. You will fall down. I have, many times. Even Ali did. But what we do after that fall is how we make history, because impossible is nothing. So don't waste your 20s. They're going to be here before you know it, and it will go fast. Be nice to your parents. I hope my son watches this one day. Be nice to your parents. They aren't perfect either, but they have been through this movie before, and they love you more than you can imagine. So go out, do the impossible, and just go on and become the greatest generation yet. Thank you so much.
From Fox's new action series, Lethal Weapon, here's Damon Wayans and Clayne Crocker.
What's up, buddy?
What's up? What was that?
Yo.
What are you doing? We're about to be like super action heroes. We got to get this right. One, two, three. I go up here, and
All right, look.
Listen, how are we going to be able to chase aliens and fight those supermodels in our rocket car?
We're not doing that show, so.
I didn't read the script.
Okay, well, can you read that right there?
I can read that. All right, here are the nominees for your choice movie drama.
Choice movie drama, 10 Cloverfield Lane. Creed. Miracles from Heaven. Boyfriend. The Martian. Straight Outta Compton.
All right, and your choice from teen drama is Miracles from Heaven.
Accepting on behalf of Miracles from Heaven are Kylie Rogers and Jennifer Garner.
Thank you. Thank you. This is for this little lady. That's for you, baby. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks for everyone. We were definitely the underdog in this category. That's so exciting. It's amazing to us the impact this movie has been able to have, and to have you guys, all of you guys, appreciate it and see it and vote for it. It means the world to us. Thanks so much to the team, to all the people we made the movie with. And what else, sweetie?
Thank you to...
No, baby. To everyone, all the kids who are in a hospital waiting for a miracle, don't give up hope.
Hi, I'm Jessica Alba. And here with me tonight is a group of brave teenagers who share an unlikely bond that's hard to comprehend. They are the brothers, sisters, daughters, and family members of recent victims of gun violence. I'm talking about Aurora, Baton Rouge, Dallas, Minneapolis, Orlando, San Bernardino, Newtown. It keeps happening, and it has to stop. Many of those impacted by these acts of violence are teens.
I'm JT Lewis.
JT was just like you until he lost his 6-year-old little brother, Jesse Lewis, one of the 26 victims of the Sandy Hook Elementary School shooting in Newtown.
I'm Jolene.
I'm Colin.
Jolene and Colin wake up every day missing their mother, Benetta Bet-Badal, who was one of the 14 people killed in San Bernardino.
I'm Shakaya.
Shakaya's life changed forever the day her nephew, Sedarius Hastings, was struck down in a senseless drive-by shooting in Atlanta.
I'm Jamal.
I'm Miranda.
And I'm Justin.
They stand here now without their brother, Jason Josephat, one of the 49 innocent people taken from us in the Orlando Pulse nightclub shooting.
I'm Patience.
I'm Tierra.
Patience and Tierra were wounded in the Pulse nightclub attack, where Tierra tragically lost her cousin, Akira Monet Murray.
I'm Cameron.
A few weeks ago, Cameron's world was turned upside down when he learned his father, Alton Sterling, was killed while selling CDs out of a store in Baton Rouge. Tonight, we stand together with these teens, united in our call for peace and an end to this violence. Now more than ever, we need to stop, feel, and ask, what's going on?
There's far too many of you, you know we got to find a way to bring some love in here today. Far, far, there's no need to explanate. See, war is not the answer. We'll be right back.
These teens had the courage to come here and share their grief and take a stand. And tonight, Neo and I and all of us here and all of you watching need to do the same. We need to come, sorry.
Okay. We need to come together as one. Now, if you feel, as we do, that we have to do better, I need you all to stand up right now and take out your phones. Come on, all over the place.
Get your phones out. Take a picture of all of these courageous teens standing here asking for the violence to stop. Then post with the hashtag, Stop the Violence. Thank you.
Your winner for Choice Next Big Thing, Kay Violet.
We all know life gets really crazy sometimes and you can't be everywhere you want to be. And for some of tonight's winners, that's exactly what happened.
So we asked them to give us some acceptance speeches in 10 seconds or less.
Here is Stride Gum's Mad Intense Winner Minute, and it's a rapid fire barrage of awards.
Okay, roll it.
Team Choice, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for all of the voting. We've got Choice Summer Music Song, we've got Choice Summer Music Star, and Best Rock Song, Deck Black Heart. You guys are the best, we love you.
I just wanted to say thank you so much for being on this room that takes me towards next year. I feel so amazing, and thank you all for the continued love.
Thank you guys for voting for us on Choice Summer Music. I'll be including an engineer song for the movie. That is so amazing. Thank you guys so much. We love you, and you're just best. We love you, Team Choice. Come on, night.
Yes, and you!
Now say hello to your Choice TV breakout star, Shadow Hunters Matthew DiDario. And from Total Bellas, your Choice female athletes, WWE superstars, the Bella Twins.
We're here to present Choice Movie Breakout Star.
So in honor of this, we are going to break out some of our signature moves.
Now this move we're going to show you can really use when you need to defend yourself. But first, we need a male volunteer.
Is the move a pun?
Never.
Now watch closely, ladies. That's right.
Okay, so let's find out who the Choice nominees are for Choice Movie Breakout Star.
Choice Movie Breakout Star. Daisy Ridley, Star Wars, The Force Awakens. Neil Setti, The Jungle Book. Alexander Shipp, X-Men, Apocalypse. Gal Gadot, Batman vs. Superman, Dawn of Justice. Brianna Hildebrand, Deadpool. John Boyega, Star Wars, The Force Awakens.
So now I hope I can get a hug, please.
No.
Yes.
Of course.
Thank you. The Choice Movie Breakout Star is... Daisy Ridley.
Oh my god, this is so scary! Oh, so many people! Thank you so much, Team Choice. Thank you to everyone that voted. It feels incredible to be in this category with amazing people, especially my boy John. And after the incredible people we just saw on stage, it feels especially important to be part of a film that represents diversity in such a positive way. So thank you, JJ and Larry and Michael, for creating this character, and Disney and everyone for letting me be Ray. Thanks!
From Black-ish, please welcome Anthony Anderson and Tracy Ellis Ross.
Hey! Okay, so before we see the nominees for Choice Movie Actors Comedy, what is on your hand, Anthony?
Oh, let's start some little thing I invented called TV Show Award History. Yeah, and you're about to make it with me right now.
Okay, is that my dashboard camera?
Yes. Uh-huh. No, maybe. Can I use it, please?
Yes, you can use it. Only because it's for TV history.
All right, now, for the first time ever, the Teen Choice Home audience will get to feel what it's like to present an award live.
Mm-hmm.
I give you the Teen Choice Presenter Experience.
Yes, this is awesome. Mm-hmm. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Okay. It's so much better presenting with all of you than just with Anthony.
I don't get it.
It's okay. It's just like it's
okay. I know, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's do it. Let's
get the noise!
party ladies gave us fits of laughter.
Now, and we will get one of them the award for Choice Movie Actress Comedy.
I admit, that's very innovative.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, very innovative.
Choice Movie Actress Comedy. Chloe Grace Moretz. Minx 2, Storm Rising. Anna Kendrick. Mr. Right. Jennifer Aniston. Mother's Day. Anne Hathaway. The Intern. Melissa McCarthy. The Fox. Nicki Minaj. Barbershop. The Next Pack.
Okay. Yeah. And your Choice Movie Actress, and your Choice Movie Actress Comedy is?
Oh no.
Thank you so much for nominating me and then voting for me to win. I think this makes me the very first actor to ever win an award for making a movie where I throw dirty tampons at a window. So I can't wait to keep inspiring you guys. Go out there, register to vote. This election means a lot. Thank you.
Coming up, hot performances by Saraya and Jason Derulo. And we reveal your Choice Red Stars and your Choice President.
Welcome back to Teen Choice. Come on now. You're still up.
Before we meet our next presenters, we want to clear a little something up. No, you have not been seeing a double. Giving out the surfboards all night long are Jay the Virgin stars and digital influencers, the Merrill Twins.
And now, please welcome from the cast of Peach, coming this fall to Fox, give it up for Mark Consuelos and Kylie Bummer.
Hey, this fall, Kylie and I star in Pitch, a show about incredible journey of the first female pitcher in the major leagues.
It has a lot of heart with a powerful message that women can do anything they want.
And this next woman is going to do what she wants to do, and that's get all of you on your feet with the first ever TV performance.
From Empire, give it up for Saraya!
Thank you.
just sitting here, not doing her job.
Yeah, well, listen, anytime anything from Empire's on, I have to sit down.
Should I binge it?
Oh, yeah, it'll change your life, man.
We should get up.
Yeah.
Okay, then. Please welcome two of tonight's nominees, Austin and Ally's Law Murano.
And from the Fosters, Maya Mitchell. I got it. I got you. Hi.
Hi. You guys have been voting all night long for your choice web stars.
Yes, you jammed up the web with all of your votes, and now it is finally time to say who you chose.
Thank you. Here are the nominees for choice female web star. Colleen Ballinger. Ava Gutowski, My Life is Ava. Gabby Hanna, The Gabby Show. Jen McAllister, Jen S. Penn. Bethany Mona. And Lily Singh, Superwoman.
And here are the nominees for your choice, male web star. Cameron Dallas. Dolan Twins. Joey Bacepa. Paige Greer. Nash Greer. And Tyler Oakley. And your choice female web star is Lily Singh. And Lily Singh is actually out of the country right now, so she couldn't be here tonight, and we will accept this award on her behalf.
Okay, well, now we're going to walk over here. And your choice male web star is the Dolan Twins.
All right, not gonna lie. My heart is beating out of my chest right now. Okay.
Mine is as well.
I'm with you. Okay, I would just like to say thank you to my family and my friends for always supporting me. And to our fans all around the world, thank you guys so much. You're the reason why we're here right now. And I just want to tell you guys something that you guys have taught me. Do whatever makes you happy and do whatever you're passionate about. Your passion can be different from your parents, your friends, your peers, anyone who surrounds you, but that does not give them a right to judge. Do what makes you happy. You deserve to be happy. You make us the happiest guys in the world.
Yes, you do.
All right, everybody, the votes have been counted, and I solemnly declare your team choice president to be Hillary Clinton! Single Kiss the Sky from the fantabulous new animated film Storks, and a medley of your favorites from his new Platinum Hits album. Give it up for Jason Derulo!
And thank you, Michael.
Thank you.
chicken roast.